Well, massive leaps in internet and cell phone technology have changed the TV industry more in the past 15 years than in the previous 50.
For sure. Sharon Crowley shows us what we're watching continues to evolve in tonight's edition of The Disruptors.
The idea of missing a show because you weren't in front of your TV set is kind of forever gone.
Never been a better time to be a TV viewer.
Television's always had disruption.
Disrupt means to interrupt the normal course or drastically alter a significant change. Disruptors are the ones responsible for making these changes, and it's happening right in front of our eyes in the television industry.
TV is changing, but it's getting better, and I think people are going to watch more and more TV. I mean, TV is really getting better.
Roku CEO and founder Anthony Wood is definitely a disruptor. His company, Roku, upended the television industry. In 2008, the Silicon Valley mogul launched the first ever Roku device to stream Netflix to the TV. Roku is now in 13 million homes.
The Roku is a streaming platform. It lets you watch over the internet television. There's over 450,000 movies and TV shows available on Roku, over 4,500 streaming channels. It's a small box. It's also built into TVs.
In 2016, Roku customers streamed 9 billion hours of video, nearly double the 5.5 billion streamed in 2015.
I think it's that combination of, at least for me, of understanding what's possible technically and then observing the kinds of problems that people have in their day-to-day lives and then combining those two into thinking about what could we build that would actually work and is possible and would make lives better.
There's no doubt that the streaming services such as Hulu, Amazon, and Netflix have changed our definition of television. How we think of the television experience has been totally transformed.
Ron Simon is a curator for the Paley Center for Media in New York City and an expert on the history and evolution of the television industry.
The whole idea of how you watch television, it was a communal experience at home. It was very easy, more family entertainment. Now television can be seen anywhere, anytime.
So it's not just where we watch, but how we watch, when we watch, and how often.
That shift of control goes from the programmer to the viewer. That's the big change. That's the big disruption. It's all about how the consumer is in control, right? You can watch on whatever screen you want, your living room, your mobile, your tablet, your desktop. You can watch whenever you want because it's all on demand, and you can watch however you want. You can watch an episode at a time or you can binge.
Peter Naylor is a senior vice president for advertising sales at Hulu. Hulu, founded in part by 21st Century Fox, the owner of Fox 5 Television, is another disruptor.
Hulu is a streaming platform where we have movies, TV shows, short form clips, all on demand. It ranges from library content from favorite shows like Seinfeld today and all of last night's shows. And super busy people don't want to be anchored to a programming grid. I mean, God forbid, 10 years ago you miss your favorite show, you have to wait for a rerun. If you miss that, then you wait for it to be released on DVD.
Another disruptor to TV? Who's producing what we watch? This year, Amazon's original film, Manchester by the Sea, Netflix's The Crown, were both nominated for major awards.
So what's the next big disruptor to the television business? Well, insiders say look for us to be streaming almost everything we watch in the future. And advertisers will be watching too, determining what we like and don't like. They'll know more about us than ever before. Sharon Crowley, Fox 5 News.